title of the game is Better You Than Me. You're playing a card game in which you represent four bullies, which are very rotten people. They just went to the amusement park and tortured and killed the cat. But the granny that owned the cat now is on a path of vengeance, and she wants to kill all of them. And this scum is gonna attack each other, so that they're gonna trip each other, so that the wench gets their friends instead of them. And the bitter end is gonna come to your friends. So better you than me. Let's start this.
I throw chewing gum in front of your foot so you stick to it.
Oh god. Actually, the clown steps in on it beforehand, so I block your attack.
It's you.
I throw a hazelnut on you so that you fall down.
I hide behind the Ferris wheel.
Also, I throw cotton candy into your face so you can't see anything.
And I throw frozen kebab.
Oh, that's heavy. That's gonna hurt.
How did you get a frozen kebab?
Hey, you're in an amusement park. Everything can happen.
Sure.
And since she's already on the ground, I throw a beach ball at her to finish the job.
I hide behind the roller coaster.
Oh, that's almost done.
I throw a banana on you.
Oh.
That's not very effective, actually.
You got trapped in the laugh tunnel, so yeah, you're left.
Oh! Beware, the granny is approaching the laugh tunnel.
But you step into green goo.
Oh, goddamn! She's doomed. She's dead. The wench got her. She's out. Guys, refill your... how much time do we have? Okay, do a second round. Fast.
Yes.
Go. He's in the love tunnel, he's in deep shit.
Alright, I'll spray you with a water gun so you can't see anything anymore.
And I'm done for.
You're done. It's ended! This fantastic music, by the way, is from Benjen. Here.
Okay, so the premise of the game is that Earth has been taken over by aliens and they've completely eradicated all life except for cats who were immune to their chemical weapons. Don't click it. So the only problem is the aliens are extremely allergic to cats to the point that they die from being in the proximity of cats. So your job is the robot that they sent in to clear out the houses so that they can move into all the houses, because the whole reason they originally moved in was to... because of overpopulation. So you have two tools at your disposal, a laser pointer to pull the cats to you, and a spray bottle to make them go away. The only problem is the thing that I didn't get finished was the actual cat disposal unit, so it's not as graphic as I wanted it to be. So it's basically just a little physics game, and you're supposed to have limited clicks to be able to move them. So we will, is it right click? What's right click here? Okay. So you can spray the thing there, or you can use a laser pointer to attract them out. That's it.
Okay, so the thing is, I a little overcomplicated the stuff and overgeneralized it. Because I made a level designer for this, which you cannot really see, so doesn't matter. The aim of the game is to find pieces on the screen and solve puzzles with it.
Like this?
That's, yeah. Where, so everything was fine, and now is everything abandoned, but I can give it to you, but I'd like to get it back, so you can try the first part of it. And the only one who can save the world is RoboCat, but RoboCat is now in pieces and you have to find these pieces and build a cat together. So that's the second part, if you are then abandoned house, and there's the piece, one of the pieces of the cat, you have to tap on it, then,
more?
Okay, then you get it. That's the first part of the RoboCat. Then you can go further in the next scene if you tap on the door. that it's open and you get in the next scene. The wonderful design, thanks from Nando. And I can give the iPad, that's the first part.
And the third theme was no happy end. I think if you assemble the cat, then it actually won't save the world, but destroy it more.
So, at first I want to show you the game itself. I didn't start the development at the jam. I started developing this game some weeks ago. The basic mechanics of this game is you just have objects of different colors, for example, which you have to move to the respective target. I already made three levels which are accessible from the main menu, but for example, there could be some other colors, multiple objects of the same color, and also obstacles in terms of objects you can move which have different sizes or different behavior, for example, only can move on one line or something like this. On this jam, I started to make the level editor for this game. Right now, there's not that much you can do. You can place... Of course. You can place different pieces, for example, extend the size of the area. And that's kind of what I got for today. Oh, and by the way, sorry for the cat.
What I made is a real-time voxelizer running on the GPU. So this is actually, if I increase the resolution a bit. So this is what I set out to make. Like, it's rendering a 3D model, which I modeled myself in like half an hour. Maybe you recognize it. Maybe you don't. You probably don't. But it's the logo of the Berlin Mini Jam sitting on something. And it's like voxelizing it into a like 3D texture in real time. And the thing that's actually slowing it down and killing the frame rate isn't the voxelization, but the ray tracing I'm doing, which is terrible. So. It took me about like 5 hours to just get like something on the screen and something compiling. But then the actual fun part is what I discovered is if you don't clear, like right now I'm clearing the 3D texture every frame. If I don't do that, you might end up with random stuff. Like...
what a surprise!
So. And the you can make a game out of that. For example, if you open this GIF, and then try to find like pixels from it in video memory, I guess that could be a game. So, for example, here, those are obviously pixels from the GIF, and to tie in with a theme. You can go to cat gifs.
Are you sure?
And load gifs of cats. And then try to find these like pixels in video memory. So yeah, that's
this is our game. It's called Fight the Ogre. And we have an ogre here who has access to the garden of the grannies, and he trampled the plants. So the grannies have to fight with them. You can join the game at this URL or just scan the QR code and play a granny and fight the ogre. The ogre has 10,000 hit points, and you have to click your mobile phone 10,000 times together to beat it. So join and click as fast as possible to beat it inside the 2 minutes.
How long do you expect this? I mean, that's
2 minutes.
Okay. Also, I mean, 1 minute and 22 seconds.
That's amazing. So.
Simon, guck mal mit.
So,
nein, das habe ich getan.
What do you do? Okay, that's actually our game. Nobody's joining yet, I don't know. It's so
me. There is people actually doing it.
So,
there is people doing it. 9,979.
Okay.
9,979.
I have to tell you too that we didn't actually implement any
hit point reduction.
you can't really beat it at the moment. And you can't really win it. You can't win it, you can't lose at the moment. The only thing that we could accomplish in these 8 hours is people connecting to it, people joining the crew, and
also and one party moving every time I tap. Or
no, you can't move. You can just get this. Okay. Thank you for your attention.
So I wanted to do a cheap, simple, like a swipey cell phone-y game. So you have a 7x7 grid with gems and one cat which is in the way. The gems have several different values. And imagine you like swipe over the whole screen and everything gem-related moves one square in that direction, except for the cat which blocks everything and moves by itself, destroying stuff. So the point of the whole thing is either to funnel the gems somewhere or to group them. Like, imagine, like, if you shift the whole board just square by square, you might want to end up with groups of stuff. Okay, let's see if this works. Nice. Okay, so this is a mock-up of the final thing. So Android style and cell phone and inviting and cute, and I'm sorry for being so casual, but I wanted to do something, you know, like happy colors and stuff. The thing in the front is actually of no use to the game. It's just so you have something to empathize with, to identify yourself with, which is something, you know, of kind of a dancer who goes like, you swipe there, he goes this, 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 and you know, he there's a certain rhythm to the thing. Okay, these are actually animations. Maybe I can get them to animate later. So these sprites ought to be animated, you know, some nice rhythm. Okay, the board. Some assets, the blocks, tiling background, nice border, a font, number font.
15 seconds left.
I have. Hmm? 15 seconds. Okay, nice. Okay, some fonts, the little guy in pixel art, and design of the alien of the cat. Okay, cat was too boring. I thought alien cat would be nicer. So an alien that's somehow identified as cat. Color schemes. Another mock-up, and we're done. See ya.
Okay, so it's basically a landless game, kind of game, where you start with a cat, and another cat was helping you. Okay, so fast, okay, fine. And basically, there is a tunnel here. So the Felix cat has to get the wool balls in order to be able to buy some upgrades and some neat stuff at the end of its tunnel. So the tunnel is totally procedurally generated, except for the textures itself. It's based on the difficulty levels, and yeah, that's what happens when you take too much damage. Okay, let me try it.
I think I'm do you have sound?
Yeah, actually we do.
Thanks for running.
Yeah. Yeah. So basically, you have to take all of this. And
I don't see anything.
It's pretty difficult. So that's not very cool. Now, at the end of its tunnel, you can upgrade your stuff, your companions. You can get Felix, you can get Tom. You can also increase the size of your companions and also their rotational speed, so it's easier to hit some stuff. And you can also repair your ship with the wood you took. But well, we sucked here, so we only had five. And then we have the next level, which is increasing difficulty at all. It's supposed to be faster, and the cubes are supposed also to be much harder to get. And that's there is at the moment there are 10 levels of difficulty. So well, yeah, collision path still to be implemented. And of course, if you lie like this, yeah. So we have 10 levels at the moment. That was it.
So we made this game, and it's rather abstract. You control this little swarm made of ink, and then there are these things, and when you come close to them, your swarm will grow. So you have more, and you're more powerful. In between, sometimes there will be these enemies, which are quite hard to defeat, and my group is quite small, so I won't attack them yet. I'll search through these abandoned corals, or whatever they are, and find another nest, so my swarm gets bigger. And now I can attack the enemy. And what you see there, the things that are on the white, that's like when some of them die, they will leave this blood. Okay, and now we kill them. That's basically the game. We hadn't that much time in the end, but that's how far we came. Benjamin made the soundtrack, and I wasn't able to implement all of it, so I'll play it in the background while we show other art stuff. So this was meant for the rather safe areas. Yeah. Okay. You tell.
Yeah, and I did visuals like I was dropping some ink, and I was blowing and blurring, and that's what.
So she actually did that on paper, and then yes, they scanned it. Yeah. Super cool.
Ooh, awesome. Yeah.
So we made a game about a cat running up a wall. You have to collect coins or get as high as you can to get a high score. And
Luca, can you help?
3 eyes, 4 eyes. Any more volunteers?
So yeah, that is pretty much the game. Yeah, well, our game is Asteroids on Steroids. It's more a tech-driven game. We wanted to do something with leap motion. I had played a game, it's called Ketchup Kulu, which I played with my son. And it's quite of annoying regarding the menu logic, because when the leap motion is not connected anymore, it's popping up the menu, and then you have to go away menu, and then you play again. So I wanted to play something which is more, or create something which is more usable with a leap motion, and this is kind of a prototype how you could do it. It's created with JMonkey engine, and leap motion. So yeah, you're controlling this ship with a leap motion, and you see we are firing stuff, and I think we have also some awesome sound effect.
So
Yeah, I'm controlling the ship with my hand through the leap motion, and yeah, we are firing, but it's not quite finished. It's just more of a prototype how you can do an asteroids-like game with leap motion and yeah, JMRK engine. Yeah, that's it.
The idea was to use your hand, like it's an ultrasonic distance sensor, and you use your hands to rotate yourself or to walk forward or backward and faster or slower. And there's also a potentiometer to increase the game speed at all, like their enemies and everything. And we just fixed that it's not smelling like plastic. And now it's spamming keys to the computer and crashing after some seconds.
So this is our hero artworks. Yeah, this is our hero. It's basically top-down perspective. Our hero is quite simple. Then I might add our background, which I created myself. which literally means I'm not able to draw anything, and I'm the worst for creating anything visual.
Don't worry, we still like you.
But thank you. That's a cat, by the way.
What?
Let me just zoom in, please. Okay, it's a cat. See, here's the hair, cat hair. Okay.
Somebody drove over.
Not a turtle, please.
Yeah, maybe you can show the zombie.
Yeah, this one would be the animation, or kind of like animation for throwing a cat.
Yeah, we're throwing cats at the zombie.
At zombies, and here's the zombie. Which actually looks like a melon. But... this could be great. We're still working on it, and we're trying to figure something. I think the Arduino's...
Beep, beep.
Yeah.
Beep, beep.
Hello, everyone. We also went with the cat-related theme, because that's the only thing that we like. Yeah.
Well, yeah, awesome. Very cool.
Yeah, because cats is like the best topic ever. And we decided to make a text adventure, and we based it on a Sherlock Holmes story, except for that Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson are cats. And like the victim is a hamster and the bad guy is a snake, and you have to like basically like get through the adventure by doing cat stuff like purring and all those things that cats do. And yeah, we planned actually to do like a whole Sherlock Holmes story, but we only got like to the middle of it. So I don't know. At first, like yeah, she like tells like the whole story of what her stepfather does and everything. And but we decide to help her, and then we get to a creepy mansion. Mansion. And then we can like look through the rooms and investigate, and like basically the sister is dead, so we like can go through the sister's room and check maybe the rope that we like play with, because we're like fairy cats and stuff. And yeah, and when we had like enough investigation time, like Watson asks us, it's like if we have an idea what happened, and of course it's actually a very obvious case if you like pray through it properly. And
you should do a traumatic reading of this later.
Yeah, probably. And we also had Vadim, who did some artwork, but he left earlier. So we actually wanted to enhance it like with actual images. And this is like an early draft of Holmes and Watson. And then this would be like Sherlock Holmes as a cat and Watson as a cat. And then imagine like also an evil snake with like a mustache and a top hat and a monocle. And the hamster in distress and everything. Mm-hmm. Imagine it great. And that's it.
The objective is to be sorry for the cats and only the cats, and then you actually can, oh, I want to make that, you can advance, and there's a score, and if and an empathy misplay if you lose. Yeah, that's basically it. It actually works. You can see it now, but it's.
So it's Splitting Shit, also known as Jedi Splitting Shit. And so we thought we would use the Oculus Rift because it's quite cool. And also like Leap Motion. And we thought that the cat theme was actually interesting, but it's bullshit actually. So we don't use any cat in our game. So it's good.
And sorry for that,
right? Yeah, no, not even sorry. I'm not sorry. Anyway, so if you play the game, it's quite cool. So let me see.
And you can play the game later on you for can yourself play the, because yeah. It's like it's obviously useless like this.
So basically, you're going around and like you will see some robots somehow because you're like a Jedi, you know, you're splitting shit. So when you see a robot, you can look at him and just make him explode. And then you can keep going. There's some cameras where like, is it a Jedi, you don't care. So you can just go forward. And some robots will try to hit you, you think, wow, die. And it just dies. Another one you can just, well, I might let you leave, but nah. You just die. Wait. And then like there's an exit. And we can get the card here. But at the end, like nothing happens. You just die again. So there's no happy ending, it's just death and good eyes. So you can try, you can try.
Yeah, this is the person. Yeah, so
in sound?
So no, so you bad done by your girlfriend, so you decide to live a life of being drunk. Smoking a lot and partying and yeah. Basically it was like a more or less like a unit experiment to try to use unit for the first time.
Pass it on a true story?
I didn't run over the cup, it was because of all the things, but yeah.
is this a midlife crisis simulator?
I never
I think you were born for this. This is your new job.
I'm really good at this game.
You have a new job here at Berlin Mini Game Jam, playing this game and being recorded. Thank you.
Yeah, the head tracking is off. That was what I was experimenting with. Normally it's just gaze tracking. The gaze tracking works quite well, I think.